me, Megan, here at FitLife. Come to talk to you today about being hangry. And hangry are the words hungry and angry put together. And let me tell you, on our fitness journeys, we might find that feeling often at first. Or when we are, like, for example, when I'm gearing up for this competition, I feel hangry quite often. And the reality of it is, when our blood sugar's crashing, we're fighting off cravings, we want those carbs, we're waiting. Like, there's a time period, like, when you're at a, you know, it's almost the lunch hour, but you're waiting, you're hungry now, and you're getting kind of emotional. You're getting a little on edge, you're getting a little irritable because you want to eat, but it's not time to eat, or you're not, you know, the food isn't readily available yet, and so you become hangry. And my husband is very familiar with this emotion that I have, and that many of us almost struggle with, right? And so that's why I always say, you know, we gotta eat every 3 hours, keep that blood sugar up, keep that metabolism going, because when we're hangry, people don't like us and we get moody, right? So I think it's just a funny expression. It's part of your fitness journey, especially in the beginning when you're trying to make those lifestyle changes and you're cutting back on, you know, the poor choices, and you're trying to learn routine and consistency. And isn't it crazy the power of food and the mind and the way it can make us feel? And so, like I say, when we're hangry, it's nothing personal to anyone else. It's an emotion. It's a real feel. The struggle is real. And just remember, the time will come, the moment will pass, the food will be put in the mouth, and you won't be hangry for long. Have a great day. Thank you.